today. The Skydive plan to present you the Skydive project. Started 1 year ago at Red Hat, this project with Sylvain Archer and Bobo. It's a real time network. So we start the project 1 year ago with Sylvain and Sylvain Bobo to design a solution based on the network topology of local memory. So why we decided to start the project internally after that? Because we see that SDN is very complex. It could be SDN over other SDN solution. Basically, OpenShift, OpenStack, OpenContract, etc. It's very highly dynamic, as we can see. All is based on software. It's not any hardware anymore. So all solutions are based on API, and obviously, it's very dynamic, by the way. And we constate, we've seen that the lack of open source tools didn't exist in any the solution. The simple tools that exist is very, very, very handy, but it's not very useful because it's specific tools like TCP, OVS, VSCTL, and very splitting. When you want to jump or see why the packets are dropped on the interface on OpenStack, you obviously you need a lot of tools and hands to find the solution, the problem. So the goal of a project is to be SDN agnostic of the language implementation. We need to analyze in real time and post-mortem the network framework basically, because when you got an issue, technically, the guys told you, "Oh, I start a VM. The VM didn't work. I stop it." So you have no any more trace of the port that exists. So obviously, we want to go back in time to see what happened exactly. One of the main goals as well was we should be lightweight, not intrusive in the networks, not intrusive in topology. Don't use a lot of processes as minimalist as we can, and so easy to deploy. So when we designed the architecture, we designed by distributed infrastructures, meaning that we started agents on one side that report the data to the analyzer. So to be easy to deploy, we did the implementation based on the one single binary that contains the network's agents and analyzers. The managers and the agents are used to record the topology on the network, meaning that we report spawn and for the topology or which we want to record, which interface, and for all the data to the analyzers. The goal of the analyzers is to aggregate all the data within the time and store it in a database, enhance it with a topology metadata, so we can know which flow was passed through which port or which interface within the networks. And all the analyzer, use a dedicated API to serve all the queries that we can ask for the networks and the flow.
Okay, so the first goal of Skydive is to build a network topology. So for this, we have Skydive topology probes. So the first one is an OBS probe. So we talked with the OBS DB can react on real time on the OVS events. So this way we get the information related to the OVS bridges, the ports, the interfaces. And so that's for the OVS, but we also monitor the other network objects, so typically using Netlink. So this way we get interfaces, statistics on those interfaces. We get the bridges, the bonds, the VLAN, stuff like that. We also make use of ETH2 to get additional information. So for example, for ETH peering, we use the ETH2. We also monitor the network namespaces. So by listening to, using I-Notify to get the newly created namespaces. We also support registering static objects. So you can register your fabric statically. And we also have connectors to external software. So those are used to get more information. So for example, when we see a network namespace, we try to know if it belongs to a Docker container. So this way we add metadata to keep, for example, the name of of this container, additional information. We also have a connector to Neutron, so we are able to get information like what is the VNI, what is the which VM is attached to this port, is it a DHCP namespace or stuff like that. We also have connectors to OpenContrail and for OpenShift too. And so with all this information, we create a graph. Typically, the nodes of this graph are the interfaces. And we connect these nodes with links. For example, our image bridge, these two interfaces belonging to this bridge, we would have a single node and two child. That's the topology we create. And we are on those nodes and links, we add metadata. So that is the information I described earlier. And there are different kind of links to connect these nodes. So that would be links that reflects a layer two relationship, or that could be ownership. So for example, the Docker is owned by this namespace. Those kind of links, and you can even create your own kind of links. So at the heart of this topology, we have a graph engine. So that is a heavily event-based. So you can even listen to those graph events using WebSocket. So that's the way the agent and the analyzer communicate. The web UI also listens to these WebSocket events. And typically your software, if you want to interact with Skydive, you can get notifications for everything that happens on the graph. And to be able to query this graph, we make use of the Gremlin query language, which is a graph traversal language that was developed by Apache Tinkerpop. So that's a custom implementation, so we support all the standard steps from the Gremlin language, but with additional steps dedicated to flows or something like that. And we also keep track of the history. So every time a node is created or deleted or updated, we keep the revisions in the database so that we are able to recreate the graph at any time. So it's especially useful for troubleshooting objects that were deleted. So here is it, a small example of a Gremlin query. See that it's using the Skydive command line. So in this case, I think we are querying all the ports attached to an OVS bridge, which is called brint. And so you get the host where this bridge belongs, and the ID and the metadata. So now I'm going to do a small demo of this topology stuff. We have in this demo there are two VMs with three VMs, one for the analyzer and two agents. And on each VM there are two physical interfaces. Those two agents are connected to a top of rack switch. We create a network namespace on each agent, a pair of ETH, all connected to an OVS bridge. And we are going to create a GRE tunnel between those two agents. So that's the Skydive web UI. So you can see the two agents with the two physical interfaces, ETH0 and ETH1, and on top the top of rack switch that connects those two agents. Now we just create a small topology. You can see that the web UI reacts in real time. So that's for the first agent and the second one. So here you can see the OVS bridge, the network namespace, this one, and the VTH that connects this network namespace to the OVS bridge, and we have the GRE, it's a GRE tab interface, and with a tunnel between the two agents. So that was a really short demo just for the topology. I can go back to. Okay. Now, that was for the topology, now we'll talk about the flows. So, first, what we call a flow in Skydive. It's a set of layers. So we see a packet, we look at the link layer, the network layer, the transport layer. We do not go any deeper right now. So for this flow, we have the source, the destination, where this flow has been seen, so the capture point. We also keep track of the metrics, so how many packets we have for this flow, how many bytes. To identify flows, we have a couple of IDs. So the first one is the ID. It uniquely defines the flow. And we also have another kind of ID, which is a tracking ID. This one is, for example, if you have encapsulation, or if you see a SSH connection on different nodes of your infrastructure, you can use the tracking ID that will specify that it's the same flow that was seen on different capture points on your infrastructure. We also have was newly introduced an L3 tracking ID. We support encapsulation, so in case see a packet that was encapsulated in another one, we create two flows, one for the outer packet and another flow for the inner packet. And we support GRE, VXLAN, MPLS, GDB. So how do we capture flows? We capture traffic, we use for OVS, we use S-flow. So that could also be used if your router supports S-flow. You could capture traffic from an external router on this way. We also use AF packets or leap backup. So how do we? What's the call flow to get traffic captured by Skydive? First, you define capture using the Skydive API. So you specify your query And so Skydive will see, interpret this query, it will see which agents is managing those nodes. It will send a WebSocket message to the agents. The traffic is captured by the agent. And every time it sees a packet, it creates a flow or update an existing flow and store everything in a local flow table. And periodically, it's going to push the flow to the analyzer. The analyzer will receive these flows and try to map endpoints. So for example, if we saw that this Mac was talking to this Mac, okay, we will try to know if those Mac addresses are known by Skydive, and it will put this information into the flow. And it will also store this information to the database. So how do we query flows? It's using the very same language as the topology. So to do that, we had to create steps that are not part of the Gremlin specifications, but are specific to Skydive. So here is just a small example. So the first one is when you have a tracking ID, so you have identified a specific flow, you can do g.flow that has with the ID of this flow and hops, and this one will tell you all the nodes where this your infrastructure where this flow was seen. So and the last one, it's another query, but using the time traveling feature of Skydive. So you can ask what were the flows that were active 1 hour ago on a Node.js bridge called Beyond. So with this in place, we can think of many use cases. The first obvious one, and one of the reasons Skydive was started, is because of troubleshooting. There could be troubleshooting for the configuration. So, has my SDN properly implemented what I said? So, do the networks where the network namespace is created, the interface, do they exist? But we also could also use troubleshooting flows. So, where my packets were dropped. This, so you could use Skydive for validation of your deployment. In fact, Orange is working with us and they are using Skydive in this way. You could use Skydive for detection of network issues, packet lost, or bad performance, just your points. One other use case would be monitoring. For this, we have a Grafana plugin, so you can draw statistics for flows. You can say, graph me all the traffic for this specific tenant or for this or the flow on the SSH traffic, something like that. We also support alerting, so you can be notified if an interface goes down or if a specific flow has too many packets, something like those use cases. You can think of like capacity planning or billing. So now I will do a small demo. So using the same topology than the previous demo, but this one, this time I will create traffic, so capture points, inject traffic, and we'll see how it's displayed on its Skydive. So this, I will create capture points. So with the right tab, I can create capture. I will select one node, another one, and I create capture on all the paths between those two points. I will do exactly the same the other agent. Here, And I will also put, so the goal is to show, to generate traffic between those two agents. So, and we'll see, and as I said, it's, we are using a tunnel, GRE tunnel between those two agents. So we see that we can, we are able to follow a specific traffic even inside the tunnel between the, those two agents. So I will put capture on the physical interface of the, those agents. So ETH1. And we also have a very basic packet generator. So I will select source interface, which is the inside the namespace of the first agent, to the same interface on the other namespaces. And if I click here at the bottom right, you can see that I saw I generated three pings between those two interfaces, so I can see that we saw three packets. And if I put my mouse over this flow, you can see all the nodes where this packet was seen are highlighted in yellow. So you can see the traffic here on this interface, and also in the physical interface. So in this case, the traffic, the ICMP packets were encapsulated. So you can see that we are. Can follow the traffic inside the tunnels. I think that's it. Okay, and now you're going to see a more advanced use case on Skydive. So this one is going to be with a video.
Is about. So it's a recorded demo because it's quite complex to deploy this one, since it is an OpenStack deployment, three bare metal nodes, and on top of it we have another chip deployment. So we can see that we have three OpenStack nodes, and kind of a green we have VMs where we have within the OpenShift deployment deployed. I'm gonna start the demo. So basically, yes, as we explained before, we have a way to get information about the node and interfaces and bridges and so on. So when we click on the node, we have on the right the metadata, and we can get more information. So here it's a VM. So we have the instance ID of the VM, for example. So we can see that we have containers since we deployed OpenShift. So it seems that this is, and we have already an already deployed app, an OpenShift app. So we can see that this is the containers of the app, this one. So it's a Postgres SQL and a front end. So we have namespaces, we have containers. And we are able to get metadata for the containers, for the namespaces, and so on. So as we have an OpenStack deployment, we also have the connector running, so the Neutron connector. So Skydive is speaking with Neutron in order to get extra metadata, like network ID, tenant ID, port ID, and so on. And we are in a nested environment, so we have a Skydive agent running within the VM and speaking to the same analyzer, so we have a kind of relationship between the hypervisor and the VM. And we have the same information for the namespaces of Neutron, managed by Neutron, like the queue router, you can see the port of the VS and so on. Basically, we have the detail for the VS bridges. We can see the local VLANs used by Neutron, by the local deployment. We have information about the QU, the DHCP managed by Neutron, and so on. So So I guess if I remember correctly, I'm going to start. We started a capture on the physical interface, just to see if we are able to see traffic. So we click on the link, we have the capture in, and we can see that we already have a lot of flows. I guess we are going to see that we have a VXLAN deployment for OpenStack, and since we have an OpenShift deployed within the OpenStack deployment using OpenShift SDN, we have a VXLAN over VXLAN. So we can see the endpoints for the tunnel. And yes, we have the package generator, so we can generate packets as Sylvain explained just before. On the top of the interface, there is a switch with a slider which helps you to go back in time when you want to troubleshoot the topology in the previous time. We have two other ways, conversation and discovery, to see the flows as well. So now I'm going to do a bit of greening regress, so we can get all the interfaces and resources managed by the neutron. It's a feature of the greening language. We can get all the DHCP, so we can see that we have three namespaces used by neutron in order to manage the DHCP of the networks. And we can get the network name for those DHCP. So three networks. So now I'm going to play a bit with the time slider. So I'm just increasing the number of pod, and so we can see that Skydive detects. Automatically the new namespace and the containers. So I just place it. So we have the information related to this container. Same for the interfaces belonging to it. And what we are going to do, we are going to go back in time, so leaving the live mode to see what was the topology before the pod creation. So we switch, we click on the switch, it's a bit long. Yeah, and we can see that we have the pod which is not there anymore because we are a few minutes ago. So before the pod creation. And what we can go back to live. Yes, we still have two pods for OpenShift, and we can go back live, and we will see that we have the pod in the namespace, which is still there. I just have to remember what I'm going to do. So I guess we are going to start a capture in order to see what Siva explained before, the capabilities of Skydive to introspect tunnels protocol. So since we are in a VXLAN over VXLAN, we are checking that we are able to follow a flow within two tunnels. So I started a capture along the path. I'm going to do the same within the VM. Meaning within the first encapsulation, since this is the OpenShift deployment. I'm going to do the same on the other side, so meaning on the another node. So the physical interface, to see the first encapsulation, and then the interface of automation. So also the kind of the second. So this is done, and now we are going to click on an interface of a VM. For example, yes, we can see that we have the traffic, so the capture has started. And if we go to the interface of a container, we can see that we have a lot of flow already there. because there is some traffic between the containers, and if you click on the this specific node, you can see where the packet is going through, and you can see the wall path between two containers, and so between two containers and two VMs. So this packet has been seen within the first tunnel, the first VXM tunnel, and the second one. So the one of the JIT and the second one is the VXM tunnel of Neutron. And if you look at the fabric, the physical interface, we can see that we have a VXM tunnel. So exactly what we saw just before, but we should be able to see the first tunnel, the first encapsulation only. Basically, just this one. So, yeah, just the encapsulated traffic of OpenJet. So now we can play a bit with the flows. So I can ask for all the flows of a given protocol, like here it's the Postgres protocol. So I can give the port of Postgres and I will get all the flows related to this protocol. I can get all the nodes where we this kind of flow that I've been seen. So that's it. So we can know exactly where between where the Postgres protocol goes. Now we are going to do something like we are going to play with the alerting mechanism. So we are going to write something in order to be sure that we have only one MTU for all the Neutron interfaces. So I'm going to start with checking that we have only one. Yes, we have only one MTU, and I'm going to write an alerting rule that is going to trigger something if we have more than one MTU for all the interfaces. And in that case, it will trigger a call to a webhook, to a HTTP server, for example. It's just a netcat, so the acting stuff is creative. So I'm going to change an MTU of a Neutron interface. So for example, this one, I'm going to load on a bit the MTU. And we can see that we got an HTTP request saying that all this alert has been triggered. But we did that for the topology, but we can do that for the flows as well. So as Steven explained before, we have a graph and a plugin. So if you want to use just a graph and a plugin that you can deploy, and you can use the exact same language, meaning the regular language, in order to graph something. So if you want to graph, in this case, for example, the Postgres SQL traffic, you can do it. You just have to copy paste exactly the same thing, the same bringing request I did before here. And it will discuss with Skydive in order to get the metrics. And you have some options like being able to see outer packet, inner packet, number of packet, number of bags, and so on. Stuff like that. I think that's it for this demo. I'm going to give the mic to Nicolas for a kind of conclusion. Okay, the presentation. Yeah, crazy. Yeah. Well,
So yeah, if you want to try to quick start, so you have a CentOS Ops Tools package already available on the Ops Tools package repositories. If you want to try quickly, you can just install this package and start with the by Skydive only one. You then start the agent and the analyzer, and you can see on your own machine what you have already, all the interface and record everything. You have already Docker and Docker composer to help us and like dev stack plugins and Kubernetes. To try the lines. Let's talk a bit about the roadmap. We plan to optimize the capture, because as you've seen today, that if you capture the, all the flow on some interface to calculate the matrix and see all the flows, but it's not always the case. The use case could be just see the bandwidth used on some interface, and we plan to basically retrieve by the network library the interface pointers. Another way as well is that we use EPPF implementation to offloading within the kernel the amount of bandwidth of the pointers for some flows. So you have the flows pointers directly on the kernel. So we plan to improve the flow classifier by opening the API to implement a special flow classifier that you can use, like for example, the GPI, like a open source one, or your own implementation. External captures could be as well a way to optimize the captures, meaning that we imagining a big infrastructure, the whole big networks, we plan to dedicate hardware to analyze just the flow on the side based on the post memory of a switch or etc. So you have a zero. It's a good way to integrate in the high-speed networks and have zero overflow over the network, and for VIP, etc. infrastructures. And fabric detection is one of the we call the roadmaps that you can in short term. Today, for the community, your project is on GitHub. You can find as well as a video of the presentation with demonstration under YouTube, like Skydive project. We based on the iPatch license, so feel free to contribute. We write everything in Go, basically, or some binding in C, but like for specific capture packets. And we use a software factory that we will present afterwards. Do you have any questions? You still have mailing list and IRC on the frequency. You feel free to contact us, we are always on. Any question? Thank you.